Alright guys, so one more thing before we move on to secondary and tertiaries. What happens if you have a primary amine? Okay, so we've got a primary amine here, but it is not the highest priority group. Okay, what if a higher priority functional group is present? Because we just talked about how amines are higher than alkyl groups. But you guys might recall that carbonyls are some of the highest priority groups in nomenclature. So what happens if I have a primary amine, but I have a carboxylic acid or some other kind of carbonyl, aldehyde, ketone, etc.? Well, then how would we name this? Well, when that happens, you're going to change the suffix amine. Okay, you're not going to use that anymore, and you're going to replace it with the prefix amino. So you're going to name it as a substituent, because the root is now going to be given to the higher priority group. So that means that now this is your root, this is your modifier. Remember that we keep referring to a modifier as anything that changes the parent chain name, right? And then the amine is now going to be the substituent. Now, how do you name an amine as a substituent? Well, you don't name it amine anymore. Now you call it amino. So if you ever heard of amino acid, right? An amino acid is going to be a carboxylic acid with an amine as a substituent. That's why it's called an amino, okay? That's beyond the scope of this lesson, but just letting you know that you've heard of this term before. So in this case, what's going to be the root name for this molecule? The root name, or the common name, would actually be benzoic acid. Okay, this is going to be benzoic acid. You guys might recall from our aromatics chapter, benzoic acid. And that means that my NH2 is going to be named as an amino, and it's going to be on which position? What number? 3, okay? So this would be on the 3 position. So what you could call this is, you could say that this is 3 amino, 1 benzoic acid. And you guys might recall that we actually have other types of nomenclature to denote these 1, 2, 1, 3, and 1, 4 relationships. This would also be probably more commonly referred to as M-meta-amino benzoic acid. Okay, remember that when you use the words meta, ortho, and para, they're just stand-ins for 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Awesome, guys. So I hope that made sense. So now let's go ahead and talk about secondaries and tertiaries.